Hi there guys, welcome back to another video. I've been meaning to do this review of Captain Marvel for a few days now. I watched it about 7 days ago in the theaters and I just kind of lost track of it. Anyhow, I went into the movie without wanting to have any kind of biasness. When I watched the ending of Endgame in the theaters last year, I was kind of excited to see, Captain Marvel. I didn't know much about the character, but I was kind of excited. That's the way the whole end credits scene was shown. And I like Brie Larson as an actress, so I thought, hopefully it's going to be really good. And I was kind of excited for it. This is all way before the controversy regarding comments made, regarding certain things about the movie, which I shall address a little bit over here. Anyhow. Let's get into the movie. So, as you know, Captain Marvel is the 21st film in the Marvel Universe, cinematic universe. I've got my notes over here, which is basically on my blog, my thoughts about the movie. So I'm going to be referencing it from time to time. Other than Brie Larson, you've got Samuel L. Jackson, you've got Ben Mendelsohn, Digimon Honsu, is that how you pronounce his name? Lee Pace, Lashana Lynch, Gemma Chan, Annette Bening, Clark Gregg, and Jude Law, who plays the main antagonist. Okay? Movie set in 1995, and you see how Carol Danvers becomes Captain Marvel. First point, although it's set in 1995, and the music, reminds me definitely of the 90s. Couple of other things like the like showing Blockbuster, a few other technology that you see in that time, the desktop computers, the slowness of booting a video or a disc or a DVD into it. That's kind of reminiscent of the 90s but other than that, I didn't really get a 90s vibe from the film. It was just those couple of things that actually the music in mainly was most of it I actually recognized. And I do love some of that music. So, I was 14 in I turned 14 in 1990, and in 1999 I turned 23. So, that 90s is a big part of me. And watching some of the scenes actually made me nostalgic for the 90s. I do miss the 90s a lot. Anyhow, moving on, Carol Danvers or Brie Larson. I felt like she was the least fleshed out superhero that I can recall watching in any of the movies. That includes DC as well and anything else. And that's because once she gets her powers, you get the feeling that there's nothing, that nothing can actually destroy her, nothing can actually damage her, nothing can actually cause her much panic. She can do it all, she's never in any grave danger, she can fly into space, and use all those super awesome powers from her fists, she can pummel any huge alien, any spacecraft, anything. So I didn't really feel like, you don't really feel connected to such a superhero. She can do everything. And it didn't matter who that particular actor or character is going to be in this kind of a role. I just didn't feel anything like, there was nothing at stake in this movie for her, basically for the character. Also for a human who's been away from Earth for a while and doesn't remember anything about Earth, I think she found her way around 1995 America very quickly and very easily. Stealing clothes, stealing the bike, riding it, all seemed like, just like this instantaneous. So I don't really know what is that she couldn't do. Also, it wasn't very convinced by Brie Larson as in that role, to be honest. Samuel L. Jackson and Clark Gregg, they were actually quite awesome to see together. Both of them de-aged digitally for their roles in this film, because it's supposed to be over 20 years ago. And it was weird for about 10 seconds, and then it kind of became natural. For the first couple of scenes, I did feel there's something odd about seeing Samuel L. Jackson that young. It looked kind of funny. Same for Clark Gregg, but after some time it kind of became very natural, and I didn't mind it, and I didn't really feel it that much. It felt more natural. The special effects in particular for everything was top notch. Just a couple of scenes where I felt like it was way too much CGI, and it felt like it was kind of like an animation movie, just a couple of scenes here there. But overall, I think maybe 95% of the time, it was pretty awesome. That's one of the best things I can say about this film. The Skrulls, a really good alien race that I wanted to see, that I saw in this movie, and I do want to know more about them. I felt empathetic towards their plight as a refugee race searching for a new home. And I like to see more of them. They're very interesting, just like the Kree are. And to be honest, rather than more superheroes, I would actually like to see a film or maybe a TV show, maybe like on Netflix or something, maybe 14, 15 episodes a season. I would like to see something, a series set on Hala, or even a couple of movies if you can set it on planet Hala. I would love to see the Kree world. Love to see their politics, love to see what makes them tick. They seem to have an interesting dynamic going on, and I really would like to see that world. I would like to see more of it. Goose the cat was a big scene stealer. She had a couple of funny scenes. I think the character is supposed to be she, but from the names of the cats that are portraying that particular character, I feel like all of them are male cats, but the character is supposed to be female. But anyway, she was a scene stealer. The only fact that I felt like it was rather unnecessary to have the cat being the reason Fury doesn't have, Fury can't see out of one eye, and he's got a patch covering it, that the cat scratched out his eye. I didn't see that one coming, props for that, but at the same time, I just felt it was kind of unnecessary. And then Ben Mendelsohn, he was pretty awesome, Ben Mendelsohn, is that how you pronounce his name, but yeah, that's, I think he was outstanding. Lee Pace returning as Ronan the Accuser. The character Maria Rambeau, who was Danvers' best friend and fellow pilot, played by the actress Lashana Lynch. I've never seen anything of hers before. They were all good in their supporting cast members. Good to see Annette Bening. I've not seen too many roles of hers. Never seen in too many men. Maybe like just the odd one here and there. So they were all good. Good cast selection, I would say, overall. Jude Law as Carol Danvers' Kree mentor, and who plays the kind of main antagonist in this film. You got the feeling that he was both a proud mentor as well as he had a deceptive agenda against Carol and against humans, so I think he did a pretty decent job. Nothing really that stands out, but yeah, pretty good. The use of the 90s rock music and a couple of rap and hip-hop songs, as well as some 90s technology, all did give it some of a 90s vibe, and I do miss the 90s, like I said earlier. I just wish there was more Pearl Jam. There was Pearl Jam, because that's what I associate with the 90s, the band that I most associate with the 90s. Nirvana was there, I believe Soundgarden at one point was there as well. Don't remember exactly, but yeah, music was a good choice. So what would I give a rating for this film? Overall, I didn't feel as engaged in the film as I normally am for a Marvel film, Marvel movie. I'm usually pretty excited, and I kind of retain the major scenes and the jokes and all that stuff in my mind. I didn't for this movie. I thought there was no bonding of the character Captain Marvel to the audience. She just felt too powerful. She's going to protect what she must. But she isn't going to be the superhero, at least from what we have seen so far, that you're going to root for, that you're going to, okay, this is my favorite. I'm not sure, at least not for me. I'm pretty sure some other people might find it more to their liking, but I just didn't feel it so much. Her powers and abilities make her almost too powerful, and that is kind of a letdown, because you want to see the superhero struggle a little bit and earn that particular, you know, respect that you can have. I'm saying this is all for fiction, but at the same time, that's kind of how I feel. So I would think, I'd give the movie a 7.5 out of 10. Special effects were great. Some of the character actors were great. But overall, I was a little bit let down. I was expecting a little bit more. I'm hoping it's just the, the origin storyline and the next movie that we get, other than Endgame, the next movie we get of Captain Marvel is going to be a lot more engaging and interesting. That's my viewpoints on this movie. It's doing extremely well. Final point, I do know about the fact that they're saying about the ticket prices, tickets being, seats being empty, and some maybe Disney's buying them out. I live in India, South India. I can't say anything for sure, but I did find it funny that about 10 minutes before I actually the movie started, I was checking to see whether there was another seat free because I saw a friend who was outside. And I thought maybe he might want a ticket. And I looked and saw that almost all the tickets except for four in that particular theater was actually sold out. And it's even gave a warning saying, closing out, sold out, almost hurry and make your purchase. So he moved away, so I didn't actually buy the ticket for him. But the theater was only three quarters filled. The seat next to me was empty, but it was actually supposed to be booked for someone. Don't know what happened. I'm not saying anything. That's just, take it as it is. Read into it what you may. That's just what I saw. Okay? I'm not saying that's part of it. I don't really think they can do that on a massive scale. I don't think Disney's going to do that on a massive scale. But I just find it odd that when people was talking about the fact that the theaters are empty, how come my theater in Loli Old Kochi in Kerala, in South India, had the same effect? Coincidence? I'm not so sure. Anyhow, take care, guys. That's all what I want to say about this movie. See you again soon.